Good morning, friends. Welcome back to the class. In the previous lecture, I have discussed pattern 3 and I got to know that there are few sums where the maximum number of students are facing the problem. So I thought before entering into the pattern 4, so I would like to discuss these four questions one after the other, and then we'll introduce the pattern 4 questions. So let's have the question directly today. So what is the question where the students are facing the problem? Is question number 13. Let's see question number 13, what it is there and how we can proceed with. So this worksheet already you have in your hand. So definitely you can go to the number, because I'm specifying the number in the pattern 3 so that you can directly observe that question clearly, right? So now what is the question number 13 we have? Tan inverse of 1 by 4 plus tan inverse of 2 by 9 is equal to half of tan inverse of 4 by 3. This you have to prove. So I am taking left hand side. So now you know how to apply the formula, or before applying the formula you need to observe what is the value of x and y. X and y both are positive, and their product will give 2 by 36. 2 by 36 is what? Positive, and it is less than 1. So hence I can simply apply the formula of tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y is equal to tan inverse of x plus y upon 1 minus xy. So now by using this formula I am going to reduce this expression on the left hand side to get right hand side. So if I apply the formula, you can simply speak tan inverse of x plus y means 1 by 4 plus 2 by 9 by 1 minus 1 by 4 into 2 by 9. Now what you will say, tan inverse of LCM would be 36, it will be 9 plus 8, that is 17, 9 plus 8, that is 17, but next again then the denominator part LCM would be 36, so 36 minus 2, that is 34, correct? So now 36 get cancelled. What you will say, then you are left with tan inverse of 17 upon 34. I think it can be get cancelled, 1 and 2, 17 1 the 17 2 sir. So finally what we are left with here, tan inverse of 1 upon 2. So these are the steps. Now if you observe the right hand part of the solution, we required 1 by 2 times of tan was something. So how can I get this half? Simply by modifying the result which I have obtained. So what I am doing here, I am multiplying this quantity with 2 and dividing the quantity with 2. So ultimately I can write this as 1 by 2 times 2 times of tan inverse 1 by 2. So if you see, it is half of 2 times of tan inverse 1 by 2, I can write like this. So purposely I am doing this manipulation because I required half as a quantity, as a coefficient. Now it is in the form of 2 tan inverse x. So now you can apply 2 tan inverse x formula to reduce the next one. So half of, now 2 tan inverse x means what? Tan inverse of 2x. 2x means 2 into 1 by 2, that is 1, by 1 minus x square, that is 1 by 4. So by simplifying this, you will definitely get the desired answer, that is half of tan inverse of 4 by 3. So this is the solution. So in entire solution, the only key point of this question is here. If you observe what the manipulation I have done, I have multiplied the obtained result with 2 and dividing the same result with 2. So that the next part become a formula, again I can use a formula of 2 tan inverse x to reduce an expression. That's it. So now we'll discuss the question number 22, that is the next one. We'll see. What is the question number 22? I am writing here. Question number 22. What we have? Tan inverse of here 6x minus 8x cube upon 1 minus 12x square minus tan inverse of 4x upon 1 minus 4x square, and we need to prove the result as tan inverse of 2x. So this is a question. Now if you see the question, it looks like a very complicated sum, but the question is framed very trickily, very smartly. So if you observe the inside factor, directly you won't get any idea. But if you want to simplify the RHS, then you will definitely get one idea to simplify this question. How? See, this is the biggest one. We are not getting any idea. So we are looking for the RHS. So what is the RHS we need to simplify? If 2x in place of 2x, if we have tan theta, so definitely tan inverse of tan theta will be theta. Means this expression become reduced to theta when you substitute 2x is equal to tan theta. So this is a one of the clue to open this sum. So I'm using that intuition to simplify this expression. We'll see how the question will be simplified by using this technique. So I'm substituting 2x is equal to tan theta purposely, you know, because by substituting this part is reduced to theta, and that is the main purpose to simplify the question. So I am using here, let 2x is equal to tan theta. So now by substituting this in the left hand side portion, what you will get? It becomes what? Tan inverse of, it becomes what? In place of 2x, I am writing tan theta. So ultimately 6x can be written as 2 into 3x or 3 into 2x. So definitely 6x can be written as 3 into 2x. I am just generating 2x in each and every expression. So 8x cube can be written as 2x the whole cube by 1 minus. It can be written as, now we required 4x square, 2x the whole square. So it can be written as 3 times of 2x the whole square. So that in every expression I am able to get 2x, so that I can replace this 2x with tan theta in the next case. Similarly here, tan inverse of, see again 4x can be written as 2 into 2x by 1 minus 4x square can be written as 2x the whole square. So if I observe this entire expression, I am having one common factor 2x in all the expression, which can be replaced with tan theta. That is I am going to do. See, if I replace that, what the expression becomes? It becomes 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta by 1 minus 3 tan square theta minus tan inverse of 2 tan theta by 1 minus tan square theta. So if you observe these expressions, definitely you got an idea that it going to reduce a formula of tan 3 theta. It's simply the formula of tan 3 theta. Then next inside factor here, if you observe, it is a formula of tan 2 theta. So tan 2 theta. So finally you are able to reduce the answer. Tan inverse of tan 3 theta is 3 theta. Tan inverse of tan 2 theta is 2 theta. So hence you got the answer as theta. Now what is theta? What is theta? If you observe the expression, what we have assumed, 2x is equal to tan theta, and theta will be tan inverse of 2x. So theta will be tan inverse of 2x, which is equal to RHS. So I think the question is very clear and very simple. What we did here, first we have observed the left hand portion. We are not getting any correct idea So then we take the help of RHS part of the solution, where the expression can be reduced by taking this inside factor as tan theta. So here we have 2x. So hence 2x can be replaced with tan theta to reduce the quotient. So I just use that intuition to simplify this. But before substituting 2x is equal tan theta, I require 2x in the expression. So that's why I am modifying each and every factor in terms of 2x. And then I am replacing 2x with tan theta in the expression. Then that entire expression is reduced to their standard formulas, and that is reduced to theta. I replace theta with the original function, that is tan inverse of 2x. Then I was able to get the RHS. I think it's so simple to understand and so simple to remember even. And this question is asked many a times in boards for 4 marks. Do you think it's related to 4 marks? But still they are asking, because the only thing is logical thinking, or you can say logical reasoning is involved. That's why this question is weighted for 4 marks. And next to question number 23, we'll see how the question number 23 will work. What we have, tan of half of sine inverse of 3 upon 4 is equal to, we have to prove, 4 minus root 7 upon 3. Well, see, the question, actually, if what is the first thinking process is, if the tan is there, so we require tan inverse inside. Right, so that is the first process to think. But if I convert this sin inverse into tan inverse, I don't think we are able to get this desired answer. Reason is, tan of tan inverse is x, but tan of half tan inverse x will not be reduced to a x or x by 2. Hence, there is no need of converting this sin into tan directly. So here, this question have some special, it's required some special skill. So see, there are several ways to discuss the same question, but I am taking one of the way where you can easily get the answer. Now what I am doing here, and for a time being, I am assuming this is some theta. Okay, so let's see how this expression will reduced. Let sine inverse of 3 by 4 is theta. So ultimately, the left hand portion becomes tan inverse of theta upon 2. So yeah, half theta you can say. So how can we now proceed with tan inverse of theta by 2? So just think, ki how can we proceed with the question? Just for 10 seconds I am giving. Let's think. Fine. So if you got the answer, well and good. If not, so no need to worry. We'll see how this question can be reduced to get this 4 minus root 7 upon 3. See what we have. First of all, we need to recall one fundamental formula of angle theta by 2, ki where this will be, where we got as what? Oh, sorry, it is a tan theta by 2, not inverse. So tan of theta by 2. Now we have a formula that tan theta by 2 can written as plus minus under root of 1 minus cos theta by 1 plus cos theta. So this is a formula which we have studied in 11th standard for angle and half of the angle, where theta is a multiple of 15. So hence we can use this formula to reduce the expression. So if tan theta by 2 is there, so I can write this tan theta by 2 with this 1 minus cos theta by 1 plus cos theta. So here I'm ignoring negative sign according to the given value. I can take only with a positive sign, but for time being I'm taking both the sign, we'll decide later on. So here under root of, what we can write it as, 1 minus cos theta by 1 plus cos theta. So in the next step, what you will say, what is the value of cos theta? To reduce it, we required cos theta value, and we know what we have assumed, this is equal to theta. So ultimately from here, sine theta would be what? 3/4. It means that it is perpendicular and it is base. So it implies that, sorry, it is perpendicular and it is hypotenuse. It implies that cos theta is equal to, hypotenuse will be remain same, that is 4, and it will be what, 16 minus 9, that is 7, under root of 7. So I am simply converting this sine value into cos so that I can use this cos theta value root 7/4 in the question. So if I substitute here, root 7/4, root 7/4, by taking LCM and all, LCM will be get cancelled, then this question is reduced to under root of 4 minus root 7/4 plus root 7. And you know, after getting this step, how to reduce this step? By simply rationalizing the denominator. So if I do that rationalizing the denominator concept, so what I am doing here, I am multiplying with 4 minus root 7, 4 minus root 7. Then the numerator becomes 4 minus root 7, the whole square, square root get cancelled, 4 minus root 7. Inside, a plus b into a minus b, that is 16 minus root 7 whole square, that is root 9, root 9 value is 3. So I hope you got the answer. See, it's so simple, no? So simple, this question is very trickily framed, which is related to this specific formula. If you remembered this formula, so definitely you will solve this question. Simply by taking this inside value as theta, that expression becomes tan of theta by 2. Tan theta by 2 formula we have as plus minus under root of 1 minus cos theta by 1 plus cos theta. And then we are using the value of cos theta. Where we got the cos theta value? From the assumption, we got the answer as sine theta as 3/4, then by you can convert this into cos theta by using Pythagoras theorem or by using identity sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So cos theta is equal to root 7/4. I am using that value. After doing that rationalization, I was able to get the answer. So this is all about your question number 23. Now coming to the question number 24. So here just I wanted to give the hint for the question number 24. Rest you can do at your part, okay? See, question number 24. Now tan inverse of root x is equal to half of cos inverse of 1 minus x by 1 plus x. Now see, it's so simple. You may get the idea of what to be substituted in the question to get LHS equal to RHS, either by observing left hand portion or observing by right hand portion. So if you see, I wanted to reduce this expression, so ultimately I have to substitute x is equal to tan square theta. If I do that, square root get cancelled, then the expression becomes what, tan inverse of tan theta, that is theta. So ultimately to reduce this expression, I required some t ratio, that is what we called as substitution technique. So here I'm assuming x is equal to tan square theta because I have root has to be eliminated, and that can be eliminated by taking square of that value. So that's why I'm taking x is equal to tan square theta to reduce this question. So if I substitute this, the left hand portion become theta, Same way you can also substitute the expression here. So x is equal to tan square theta if you substitute. So it become 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta. This will be the formula of what? Cos 2 theta. So cos inverse of cos 2 theta is 2 theta. And 2 to get cancelled theta. So hence here you are able to get both the values are same. LHS is equal to RHS. So this substitution will work to prove LHS is equal to RHS. I am leaving the entire solution, written solution for you people only. So just take this hint to simplify this question. So I hope your doubts are maximum cleared in pattern 3. Now the pattern 4 questions we are going to discuss. Let's have a discuss the pattern 4, what we have in the sheet. So before discussing pattern 4, please keep the worksheet which I have given to you in front of you. If you have thorough in the formulas, well and good. If not, keep that formula list also in front of you so that we can easily use your formulas to discuss the questions. Fine. See. Now we are going to discuss pattern 4. So in pattern 4, if you observe the questions are asked like simplify. The heading, common heading of all these questions is simplify. So now we don't know what is the last step of the question. That is the biggest constraint of these type of questions. When they say simplify means reduce the expression as much as you can, and we don't know what is the actual final step of the solution. So that's why we may get into wrong answers, we may get into mid of the answers like. So that is the biggest constraint of this pattern 4. And secondly, to discuss pattern 4, you must thorough with the formulas of trigonometry of 11th standard. So if you remembered that fundamental formulas of 11th standard, you will definitely crack this pattern 4 with your fingertips. Let's say, how many questions we are going to take here. Most probably we are going to take 6 to 7 sums. 7 questions we are going to take. Apart from this, rest of the questions are similar, so you can practice yourself. Now let's see the question wise, directly coming to the question, right? Question is what? Simply simplify. So simplify the expression. Now I am taking question wise. Fine. So pattern 4, question number I am taking 28. See, I am taking directly question number 28 here. You have a set of questions, 10 to 12 questions we have in this pattern 4. Now see what we have. Tan inverse of cos x minus sin x upon cos x plus sin x. And some conditions are given where x is lies between 0 to pi. It means that angle, whatever the angle is involved that lies between 0 to pi means first and second quadrant. First and second quadrant. Now see how to simplify. The question is simply simplify. We don't know the answer. What to prove? That is the biggest constraint. Wherever if we have that RHS part, so we can get some intuition what to do, how to proceed. We'll get some idea, but if it is not there, simply they said simplify the expression. So we don't have any exact idea what will be the last step of the solution. So in this case, every step is an answer, but we'll try to reduce the expression to a maximum extent, right? Now see how to get into the questions. Before discussing this type of question, I will give one small hint here. See, and you can follow this hint wherever this type of sums coming. See, what is that? Ki if the expression in the form of tan inverse of x minus y by x plus y. Tan inverse of x minus y by x plus y, you can simply do one thing, ki whatever the quantity in the denominator, that is the beginning part of the denominator, what we have here, x. So we can divide this inside factor, that is numerator and denominator, with x. When we divide it, it converted into a standard formula. This is the smallest hint you can use to reduce this type of expressions wherever we have, right? Now I am dividing the numerator and denominator with x. So what you will get, just see the expression, how it can be reduced. So if I divide the entire expression with x, means each term is divided by x. So ultimately become 1 minus y by x by 1 plus y by x. So it is in the form of what? Tan inverse of. Yeah, I can also write the name, the next step, tan inverse of 1 minus y by x as it is by 1 plus. I can write this y by x as 1 into y by x. Expression remains same or not? So it is in the form of tan inverse of x minus y by 1 plus xy. It converted into a formula of tan inverse of x minus tan inverse y. So tan inverse x means tan inverse 1 minus tan inverse of y by x. See how beautifully this expression is reduced to a simplest form. So now tan inverse 1 means pi by 4 tan 45. So hence I can write this with value pi by 4 minus tan inverse of y by x. So it's so simple to write and do the questions. See, you can use this now expression as a formula wherever the expression is in the form of this. Tan inverse of x minus y by x plus y can written as pi by 4 minus tan inverse y by x. So I am taking this formula, right, to simplify this type of questions. What we have, tan inverse of x minus y by x plus y is simply written as pi by 4 minus tan inverse of y by x. So I am going to use this formula to reduce the expression. So you can remember this formula wherever we require, we can use this. Now I am going to use this formula to reduce the expression. So what you will say then? Answer would be, in place of x, what we have? Cos x. In place of y, we have sin x. So simply apply this formula and speak the answer. What you will say? Pi by 4 minus tan inverse of y. Y means sin x upon cos x. So you can use this formula in boards also, no need to worry, it's a standard formula, derived formula. Sin x by cos x is tan x. Your answer is pi by 4 minus x over. I think it is so simple. Now just by using this formula, you are able to solve the many of the questions which are related to this. So let's see the another question where you can apply the same formula to reduce the answer, right? Now see. I'm keeping the formula same because we are going to discuss the next question related to the same formula. Let's see. The next question is question number 29 from the worksheet. Tan inverse of a cos x minus b sin x upon b cos x plus a sin x. where some condition is given where a by b times of tan x is greater than minus 1. So this we need to simplify. Again, it in the form of like x minus y by what we called as x plus y. अगर ऐसा फॉर्मेट में है चेक कर सकते हैं हम लोग. सो क्या हम देख रहे हैं यहाँ a cos x by b and the same expression नहीं है. x minus y by x plus y होना चाहिए था बट वो ऐसा नहीं है बिकॉज a एंड b कोफिशिएंट रिवर्स है. सो हम डायरेक्टली इस फॉर्मूले को तो अप्लाई नहीं कर पाएंगे बट द टेक्निक विच वी हैव यूज टू डेराइव दिस फॉर्मूला वी कैन यूज इट. इट्स सो सिंपल. सो वॉट वी हैव डन wherever the expression in the form of tan inverse of x minus y by x plus y or x plus y by x minus y, whatever, plus minus doesn't matter. So we are going to divide the entire expression with this quantity. Always keep this quantity in your mind, right? Isse hum divide karenge numerator and denominator ki each and every term. So ultimately that reduced to what? Tan inverse of, if you divide with b cos x, so ultimately the first term reduced to a by b, second term is reduced to tan x, third term completely divided, so 1 plus, if you divide this with what you will get, so a by b into tan x. So this is we have. So now you can easily guess this has become a formula of tan inverse of x minus y by 1 plus xy. What you will write? I'm writing the formula here to understand very clearly. Tan inverse of x minus y by 1 plus xy, which can be written as tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. This is simply a formula. So in the next step, I can write by using this formula here. So in place of x we have a by b, in place of y we have tan x. So simply write, use this formula to reduce the expression. It reduces to tan inverse of a by b minus tan inverse of tan x. So tan inverse of tan x is x. So simply you can write, now the final answer is tan inverse of a by b minus x. This is your answer. I think it's hardly a two-step sum. So even if you observe the question here, it is not exactly in the form of this. That's why I was not able to use this formula directly. But the trick which I have used to derive this formula, I'm using wherever it is required. I'm dividing the entire numerator and denominator with b cos x. So this is the only key factor to reduce. So if I use that, so I was able to get the simplified answer. So I can also use the same one for the from some more questions. We'll see how this technique will work in other questions too. Yes. I'm taking one more question. Question number 31. We'll see what is that. So tan inverse of a by b minus tan inverse of a minus b upon a plus b. So it's so simple. You can apply this formula here in this part. So then rest will be simplified. So chalo koshish karte hain ki kya hame answers milte hain isme. So, अगर हम देखते हैं कि यहाँ x माइनस वाई बाई एक्स प्लस वाई वाला फॉर्मूला अप्लाई करते हैं तो आर वी एबल टू रिड्यूस द आंसर ऑफ नॉट. इफ नॉट देन विल रिवर्स सम टेक्निक. ओके चेक करते हैं. सो टैन इनवर्स ऑफ ए बाई बी इज इक्वल, सॉरी माइनस. सो इफ यू अप्लाई दिस फॉर्मूला डायरेक्टली व्हाट यू विल गेट इट एज pi by 4 minus, in place of x what we have a, in place of y we have b. So simply apply this formula, what you will get, minus pi by 4 minus tan inverse of b upon a, correct. So what you will get the answer as tan inverse of a by b minus pi by 4 plus tan inverse of B by A. So this is a final answer. But if I so once it is done, now see if you see the answer, it is not reduced to a simplest form. But if I use a little bit change, if I do the some small changes in the question, you will see the change in the answer even. Okay, see how it will work. So here, if you take this part separately, right, I'm just simplifying this part separately, how it can be reduced. Tan inverse of A minus B upon A plus B. If I divide, instead of dividing with A, if I dividing with B, what you will get? Tan inverse of A by B minus 1 by A by B plus 1. Other way also we can written as A by B minus 1 by 1 plus A by B, because addition is commutative. So this is reduced to tan inverse of A by B minus tan inverse of 1, that is x minus 5 by 1 plus x5, because now I can write it as A by B into 1. So hence it reduced to tan inverse of A by B minus pi by 4. So hence this can be written as tan inverse of A by B minus pi by 4. If I use that, what you will get? Tan inverse of A by B minus bracket ke andar hum likhenge tan inverse of A by B minus pi by 4. So if you open with this minus sign, what you will get? Tan inverse of A by B minus tan inverse of A by B plus pi by 4. So these two are get cancelled. Answer is pi by 4. So this is the technique behind this question. Instead of dividing with A, I am dividing with B, because first I do the same one with the regular process, dividing by A. If I do that one, I was not able to reduce it to simplest form. But when I do the same one with B, it means there are two possibilities. Sometimes we need to divide with A, sometimes we need to divide with B. But in most of the cases, 99.99% cases, the first term say hum divide karenge. But after dividing that, if you are not able to reduce it, so better to take the second term. This is another way to think. Fine. So this is a question number 31. So now let's see. So here we'll end up with the class, and the rest of the questions you may try. If you have any doubts, so we'll discuss the questions later on, whatever the doubts we have in the pattern 4 in the next video. So keep on watching this video and take care of yourself and be happy.
Yeah, no problem.